Greetings, beautiful souls. It is your sister at heart. My name is Princess Yanja, and I am here again with another motivational soul healing video. If you're coming for the first time, please do press the subscribe button down below and press the notification bell so that you will be notified every time I upload a new video. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being part of the family. I truly appreciate you being here. Without wasting any more of your time, let's just go straight to today's video. It is very important to take care of our mental health. I strongly do believe that with our mental health in place and as healthy as possible, we can achieve a lot of things and break a lot of generational curses in our own bloodlines by just accepting that we are not okay because we went through some things that might have been dark, and really just see those things for what they truly are and embrace the experiences that we go through as we experience the darkness and utilize the strengths that we come out with and also the wisdom that we gain after dealing with some low vibrational experiences, situations where we have to heal from our own parents. And this is something that is necessary, especially if you are the chosen one, because when you are the chosen one, you are much likely to be born by parents or in the family of people who are narcissistic. And the reason why you are being brought in that particular family is for you to break the pattern. It is for you to be the first person to feel the pain, because these people really, they tend to ignore the pain and act as if it doesn't hurt. And years later, you find that they have to suffer the consequences of leaving the unhealed wounds undealt with for a lengthy period of time, that they start inheriting down these behaviors and these patterns and these generational curses to their own offsprings and their own generations that come after them. So it is very important to heal. And when you heal and when you choose healing, you have to keep it in mind, Uti, it's never just about you. When you choose not to heal also, it's not just you who's going to be suffering the consequences of not going through the process of healing. So we have some people who are the chosen ones who tend to be very open about their experiences, especially in the line of work where I get to interact with different people who open up with their situations, especially during our sessions. I did come to a realization that there was a certain pattern, especially with the so-called the chosen ones. They tend to be born in the family of narcissistic people or parents who are narcissistic. First and foremost, you need to understand, Uti, when you are dealing with a narcissistic mother, you're going to have to do some healing in the near future. In this particular video, I'm going to focus on mothers. And these are the cases, like I said earlier, that are very common in our society. And you find that in certain places, people are not allowed or don't even feel free enough to be open about these experiences because it is a taboo, especially in our African society, to have issues with your own biological parents or your family. It looks as if you as a child, you are the problem, or you are the one who does not obey the rules or the laws or even respect your parents. But sometimes you do get those parents who are really just nonchalant kind of parents, parents who don't have any attachment with their children or their offsprings, including their great children or great grandchildren. There are people who give birth to children that they tend to be jealous of. So those are all the signs of a parent who is narcissistic. These are the type of people who prioritize themselves more than their own children. They put themselves first in each and everything and decision that they take. So they have no ability to be able to sympathize and feel sorry and be really emotionally connected with these people that they coexist with. So now when you grow up under the care of a parent who is like that, you best believe that you're going to need to do self-care in the near future so that you do not do the very same thing towards your own children. Mother wound is something that you can go through as a person, especially as you grow older. You realize that you have mother wound that you need to heal. You find that you need to go back and really just see your mother for what she truly is. There are people out here who are born by narcissistic mothers, mothers who put themselves first before their children. And this is seen in the decisions and the actions that they take on their life or with their lives or about as they go about with their lives. But as a child, as an adult child, there'll come a point where you need to then now mother yourself and really put yourself in her shoes. Narcissism is some sort of dark energy that tend to affect people who might have been exposed to also dark spaces and dark people as well. So they didn't just get born being narcissist. They were exposed into situations that instead of healing, they chose to embark on the same journey that was embarked on by their own perpetrator. So the difference between the chosen one is that the chosen one is going to do the opposite once they see that there is some injustices and some unfair behavior or treatment in the family that are done by people who are narcissistic. That's the difference. They would want to do the opposite and stop the unfairness in the family. So when you have mother wound, you are much likely to have issues when it comes to relationships. As you grow older, you'll find that you cannot stay in a lengthy period relationship because you feel irritated, you cannot compromise, you can't come to an understanding with the person that you are in a relationship with. For an example, when you see adult men who have unhealed mother wounds, they are much likely to really hate women in general. These are the type of men who will still date women, but they will not have the attachment with them because they wanna punish them on behalf of their own mother. So you find that these people, they tend to be very, very unemotionally connected with the people that they're in relationships with. They are scared of commitment or long-term commitment. They cannot commit to one partner. They feel the need to have several partners, but they still can't find what they're looking for, even from those different people. And it works exactly the same with women as well. Women, when they have issues with mother wound that is unhealed, they tend to be people pleasers, both with men as well. Especially for women, they people please towards women. Anyone who is in their inner cycle or in their life who is a female, who is a prominent position or somebody that they really admire or respect, they will not know how to have a healthy relationship with those people. They'll feel a need to people please and really just throw themselves on the floor trying to please these people and be in these people's lives. They act with desperation instead of being in places where they are appreciated instead of being tolerated. So there are a lot of behaviors and a lot of things that can hinder your success just because you have an unhealed mother wound. An unhealed mother wound is your responsibility, unfortunately. And as much as you might be a victim of a narcissist through the hands of your own mother, these are the type of people, or these are the children who will grow up with resentment because you never really got to confront these people or these parents. And even if you do confront them, you will never get a straight answer and why they took the decisions that they took. And if they did tell you the decisions, they're always going to be based on self, nothing but themselves. So you need to know that now you need to care for yourself at this point so that you do not allow this wound or this curse to fall down to your own kids as well. You need to make sure that you make things right with yourself. Forgiveness, more than anything, is important. After anger, each and every emotion that is involved in this process needs to be processed so that you do not go back and forth with your healing. There comes a point where you need to be really angry and really just be judgmental towards these people. Now that you know better, now that you are a parent, you know that you would have done better as a parent that you are today. Or even if as an adult, even if you are not a parent, but you now see things clearer and better. You are now an independent thinker. You are able to see things for what they truly are yourself. So you are able to come to realizations of how they might have taken, how your parents or your toxic narcissistic parents might have taken decisions that were always against your safety, that were against your best interest, but it was always about what they needed at that time for themselves as individuals. So you come to the point where you need to really heal. Some people, they end up going to therapy. Some people really just take away from family, from work, from everything, and then travel to really just try to find self. If I can say, the most effective way that can help you to not only realize that you have mother wound, but also to start the attempt of the healing journey, is to mother yourself the best way you know how. Tell yourself all the things that you wish your mother would have told you as you were growing up. Believe in yourself in a way that you wanted your mother, your biological mother, to believe in you, the way you would have wanted her to believe in you. And when you have gone through the anger stages, don't stay there for too long. Come to the point where you really now start studying their own trauma. Remember that trauma is also passed down from the parents. Ingakho isiZulu sithi izono zabazali ziwele ezinganeni. So you're always going to have to go through situations and difficulties that are passed down by the parents who brought us in this world. you need to come to a realization where now you see them for what they are, as human beings, not as your parents, and look at how they grew up and the things that they might have known or the things they lacked from knowing, and the behavior and the lifestyle they were exposed to, and start really understanding why these people behave the way they did, because they didn't know better. Anyone who knows better can always do better, but someone who was shown a faulty example of how to be a mother, they will always bring forth very disappointing result. You find that some people have mothers who were raised by step parents who were not so loving. Some were raised by extended relatives who were really not that accommodating. So they are always constantly trying, you know, to find themselves fitting in. They find themselves being in relationships and creating friendships with people who dislike them, because that's the pattern that they're used to from beginning. So they are always looking for a chase, to chase people, to make sure that they are accepted, they are understood, they are within belonging somewhere within some particular groups. They don't know how to be independent and think independently. You always feel the need of wanting to be part and parcel of a group or of some sort of thing. Not realizing that the more you do that is the more you shy away from your own healing. Healing needs you as a person, as an individual person as you are. With no crowd, with no audience, just yourself. That is how we heal. Whatever that you go through as a human being, it penetrates through spiritually. It penetrates through the cellular level. It controls you. It takes some particular control or power over you until you truly understand your situation and work around it and find the outcomes that are going to be suitable for your liking. Until you do that, you will constantly find yourself being in situations where you're repeating the cycles of those who were once here. And these cycles are not always going to be the positive cycles. But the main reason why we are here, especially if you believe that you are the chosen one, you are here to change things around. Now, last but not least, I know that this part of the information might not be really relevant to this particular video, but I think it is important for me to mention this, Uguti. If you are the chosen one and you find yourself, you are struggling with addictions, whatever the addiction you might be having, it might be anything. It could be food, it could be sugar, it could be anything. It could be even just beautiful things like exercising. Maybe you are becoming excessive, you are overdoing things, there's no balance in your life. You know, Uguti, that's a sign that there is an issue with your root chakra. A root chakra is much likely to be imbalanced because of such things as mother wound, things such as mother wound, father wound, things such as the need of shadow work. When you are not sorting out your traumatic past experiences so that you can prepare for the new phase that is coming in your life, you are still operating in the old space, even though now you have grown as a person, you are now ready to enter into new spaces, but you are still playing in the same field until you allow yourself to really see things and people for what they truly are, not because we wanna hate them or we wanna judge them, but because of your own healing. Allow people to be what they are and who they are for your own healing. It's not for the purpose of judging them and acting as if we are better than them or becoming superior than anyone, but it's all about just getting more informed and well educated so that you will know what is it that you need to fix should you decide that you want to start fixing your life and putting everything up to date as it should be, especially with regards to your mental health. Mental health is everything. Mental health is important. When you feel that your parent might be jealous of you or they envy your life, they always in competition with you, and you don't feel that attachment that you're supposed to have as a mother-child, a relationship, there's no empathy. Even when you share your sorrows with them, they don't seem to be taken back, or they don't seem to be touched. They don't seem to be empathizing with your downfalls or your hardships. You know that you might be dealing with a narcissistic mother who just is unable to feel empathetic about anything or anyone other than themselves and those who they care for the most, who they benefit one thing or another from. So just know that you are dealing with a narcissistic mother. I hope that we use this as part one, and then we will do part two, possibly on Monday or Wednesday this coming week, where we're going to then take it further and talk about the mother wound from the narcissistic mother, how it looks like, and what are the things that you need to do to then find yourself coming out of that situation. Because we need to start to listen and help each other to really come out of these toxic situations so that you can really realize your truest version of your power, so that when we speak about power and we speak about this melanin being that you are, this person who have the nine ether hair that is connected to the heavens, this person who have celestial ancestors who is connected to the source, you need to feel what we're talking about. But if you're still struggling with things such as narcissistic energies, such as narcissism in your inner cycle, then that is going to delay, and it's going to take some time for you to reach to the point where you really start hearing the messages that you need to start to hear, that are going to navigate or help you navigate through your path that you were brought here to navigate and to contribute where you needed to contribute. Everything starts with your mental health. You will not be able to pour from an empty glass, so make sure that your glass runneth over before you are able to give anything back to anybody. You come first. Your mental health is your priority. When you are healthy, when you are well and you look great, you tend to feel great and you tend to be a great influence even towards those who are close to you, who get to benefit being an amazing person in their life that you are. And also, you know, you need to understand, as you can be a very, you can be an amazing person, but when you are surrounded by a dark cloud of being in contact with a narcissistic person, worse if it is a life partner or a spouse, you find yourself, no matter how much you work hard, no matter how much you try to meditate and manifest and affirm positivity, you will find yourself walking 5 steps front and 10 steps back all the time, because it's this stagnant energy that is in your space, in your cycle, that is just operating and taking over. So you need to make sure that within yourself it's clear, your conscience is clear. All the resentment that you might be having towards your parents, there comes a point where you need to come to forgive them and see them for what they truly are, not because you are belittling them, but really because they were unable to do the things that they were supposed to do. They became parents before they were meant to be parents, but they did a beautiful job to be the transportation or the career that brought you here. So you are the one who needs to compensate and change the story for the people who might have been your transport to bring you here. By making sure that you're walking on your path with grace, by making sure that you are walking on your path that is yours, by making sure that you are living and fulfilling your life purpose at all times, and that you really enjoy life more than anything without harming and hurting anyone in the process. It's the simple things really that make us even more amazing. It's the simple things that make our light radiate even more and illuminate even stronger and further. It's all about the energy that you release as you speak, as you walk, as you interact with other people, as you love yourself, as you grow yourself. Everything that you do, touch, see, speak, it lives, it becomes a living thing. So make sure that you are also aware of that, especially when it comes to other people as well. Whatever that they touch, that is yours, that they see, that they speak about you, it becomes something that have a potential of being reality if you have allowed them a certain space in your life, especially if it's an important space that you have given them in your life. You best believe that they will definitely have a contribution in what will come about with your life. I hope that this video did come and find you in good spirits today. I hope that you will find the truth that you're seeking for, and I hope that the healing is part of your journey and it is your priority at this point, for your own benefit and those who come after you. So from me to you, all I can say is I'll see you on the flip side. Love and light.